गुड मॉर्निंग गाइस, इन टुडेस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द सप्लाई एनालिसिस। ओके, फर्स्ट वी विल सी द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द सप्लाई एंड द स्टॉक। ओके, स्टॉक इज जनरली द अमाउंट ऑफ goods currently available for sale, right? You know that stock is the amount of goods currently available for sale. Generally we call it as stock. Okay, we generally stock is regarding the inventories. What is this inventories? Inventories means we may have a finished good, or else we may have the goods which are in the process, right? We have some goods which are in the process. It is not fully finished good. Generally we also consider those as the inventories, right? Next, what is the supply? Supply is the amount of goods that seller offers to sell at various prices. Okay, supply is the amount of goods that seller offers to supply at various prices, right? Next, we have different types of sellers. Rational sellers who is to maximize the profits. Okay, supply is a flow of goods at various prices. Okay, the thing we can it can be seen in the schedule diagram. Okay, so we'll see different definitions of this supply curves also. So first we'll see law of supply. Here the law of supply, actually we are studying after this law of supply after the law of demand only, right? So remember or recall once again the law of demand. What is the law of demand? Law of demand says that as the all other components remaining the same, we will be calculating, that means we will be identifying, we will be analyzing the demand or demand curve. We are observing the demand curve only between the price of the product and also the demand, right? So when the price of the product increases, the demand decreases, and the when the price of the product decreases, the demand increases. Inversely related, right? If you remember once again the demand concepts, if the price of a particular product decreases, the price of the particular product decreases, automatically demand increases. If the price of the product increases, automatically demand decreases. That is the general scenario in the demand concepts, right? Now, but the supply concept is little bit contrast to that. Okay, generally this supply, if the price increases, if the selling price of a product increases, the supply will be increased. Okay, if the selling price is decreased, if the selling price is decreased, the supply will also be, the supply will be decreased. Do you get now? In the supply, if the selling price increases, if the selling price increases, the supply will be increased. If the selling price decreased, supply will be decreased. Okay, why it is so, that thing we'll see here, right? Here in the law of supply, all other things remaining the same, remaining the constant, all other things remaining the constant, quantity quantity supplied of a commodity is positively related to its price. Positively related to its price. SQ is nothing but the quantity quantity related to the supply. Quantity related to the supply. It's a function of the price of that particular product. Not only this, it is a function of many other factors also. Those are called as the determinants. We'll see those also. Okay. Next, this is the thing. Higher the price, higher the quantity supplied. Generally, supply curve slopes upward to the right. Upward to the right. Higher price means higher profit margin. Given cost. That means, see here, higher price means higher profit margin. Given the cost. That means, here the cost is same. Cost is not going to vary. Cost is nothing but the amount what we spend on that particular product for producing, right? Then selling price is the one which we are willing to, that is the price we are willing to sell. That means we are including some amount of profit. So if the selling price is more and the cost is not varying, if you supply more number of goods at that particular selling price, automatically there will be high amount of profit, right? The thing we already know. Higher price means higher profit margin. Right. So if the selling price is higher, but the cost is same, if you are supplying more number of goods, automatically there will be high amount of profit, right? So that's the reason why the seller increases their supply when the price is higher, right? For him, no bother, right? Because the cost is same, but if he is able to produce more number of goods and if he is able to supply more number of goods, that since the selling price is higher, he will be getting more amount of profit, right? Okay. So see here, his the supply curve. So if you take the left side, the price of the product in rupees and the quantity supplied in kgs, say here, if it is half rupee, he is supplying 1 kg. When it is 1 rupee, he is supplying 2 kg. When the price of the product is 1.5 rupee, he is supplying the quantity 3 rupees. When the product is selling price is 2 rupees, he is supplying 4. See here, the price is increasing gradually. The price is increasing gradually and the quantity supplied is also increasing gradually. So it will be, you can observe here, right? So you can see here, it's just like your ramp signal, what you have studied in your signals and systems. Okay, actually in practical it will not be like this. It will be just like a curve. It will be just like a curve looking upward, right? Okay, what do you understand from this? In the supply, yes, there is increasing. Yes, there is increasing in the selling price, automatically there will be increase in the quantity supply. Why? Because the supplier want to make profit. So he will be supplying more products. But one thing we have to keep in mind, we are saying that all other things remaining constant. Okay, all other things remaining constant means there is no effect of his supply. That means, for example, if you are a supplier of, that means if you have an ice cream industry, for example, here now, we'll see. You have an ice cream industry, you are willing to supply ice cream to the sellers, that means the dealers, you are the main producer of the ice cream there, and there will be dealers in between and there will be sellers. Okay, so the sellers will be asking the dealers, we want more amount of supply because there is a good demand for your product. So they ask the dealers to supply more amount of your ice cream, right? you are the manufacturer. That means you are the producer of the ice cream, right? So the prices is increasing. They don't bother if your ice cream is good enough in quality. Okay, if you increase the price also, if you increase the price also, the customers are ready to buy that particular product. So what they do is they will gradually increase the price of the product. At the same time, they will gradually increase the supply. Okay, after increasing the price, they will increase gradually the supply also. That will make you more amount of profit, right? That is the concept of the supply. Okay, see, I said that all other things remaining constant. So there are some concepts which are affecting the factors of the supply. Okay, there are some concepts which are affecting the supply. Okay, see here, price of the commodity. So what is this price of the commodity? I am saying that now I am taking the example of ice cream, right? Price of the commodity means here price of the ice cream. The factors affecting the supply is the price of the ice cream itself. Okay, more is supplied at higher prices, less at lower prices. For example, you think that for producing an ice cream, it costs you 10 rupees. Do you understand? For producing an ice cream, if it costs you 10 rupees, due to the lack of market, if the price of the price of that particular product is at selling price of the product is at 8 rupees, for example, what happens? Or else, yes, if the price of the product is at 8 rupees, you can't supply, right? Why? Because your cost, your selling price is at that means your cost is at 10 rupees, but you can't sell at 8 rupees. So what you do is, to exist in the market, just to exist in the market of the ice cream, you will be supplying. Even though you get loss, you will be supplying, but you will be supplying at a very less amount of ice creams. Why? Because you already got more amount of profit. If you simply close the business, immediately after closing your business, if there is a huge demand and if you are unable to supply those, you will lose the market. That means you will be having loss, right? We can't simply close the business as we are going to have the loss. We have to bear the loss for some time, and immediately there may be some profits. But what we do is, to exist in the market, we will be supplying very less amount of goods, right? To avoid the heavy loss, we will be supplying less amount of goods at that particular selling price. So these things we will be understanding in the business cycles. If there is huge increase in a particular product price, definitely there will be huge decrease in the price also, within no time. Okay, within some short span of time, there will be decrease in the price also. Okay, see here, when we go with this factors affecting supply, first one is the price of the commodity itself. Okay, more is supplied at the higher prices and less at the lower prices, right? And not only that, so to ship your ice cream, that means you are manufacturing, or you are producing the ice cream, and it has to go to the dealer. Yourself has to supply it to the dealer, and the dealer will be supplying it to the retailer, who is selling directly to the customers, right? So for doing that particular task, refrigeration charges, transportation charges, and also some other products. Okay, some other, what you say, some other factors affecting that. To make ice cream, you require milk, right? And you require some ice cream powder, right? Some other key ingredients. Say, if you are making some badam flavor, you require some badam, right? Sorry, almonds, right? If you are designing almond flavored ice cream, you require almonds. For cashew flavor, you require cashews. That means there are some other components also. That means the key ingredients of your ice cream that will also affect the your supply, right? Okay, prices of the related goods also going to affect your supply. So substitutes, if price of the tea falls, the demand for the tea increases. Okay, but demand of coffee falls, so supply of the coffee falls. This thing we already seen, what are substitute goods and complement goods, right? So for the substitute means, for example, substitute means for the instead of coffee you can take tea. Then what about this complements? Complements of that particular tea is either milk or sugar. These are the complements, right? These price of the related goods are also going to affect the supply chain, right? So see here. We have other factors affecting the supply, that is seller's expectations. So seller's expectations, we expect that input price to fall in the future, he increases the supply today, right? That means for example, the selling price of your ice cream is going to decrease. Generally, if you think the concept of ice creams, generally everyone used to eat ice creams in hot weather generally, or else if the rainy season is going to come in near future, there will not be huge demand for the ice creams. So what they do is, so as there is less demand, automatically the selling price will be decreased, right? Okay, so if the seller expects that in near future there will be decrease in the price of the particular good, he increases the supply today itself. He increases the supply today itself, and so except expect the input price to fall in the future, he increases supply today itself. Why? Because he want to make profit at the present price itself. Do you get now? What he is doing, he is expecting that in near future there will be decrease in the selling price of that particular product. So to avoid if he supply now more itself, he'll get more profit now itself. And what he do is, when there is a fall of the price, he will decrease the supply, so he will face less amount of loss at that particular point of time. Now he will get the more profit. Okay, now he will get the profit. Okay, so expect the price of the goods to rise in future. Sometimes he expect the price of the goods to rise in future and decrease the supply now. There are two conditions, right? Sometimes, so here expect the input prices to fall, right? So So he increased the selling price now itself, right? So he expects the price of the goods to rise in future. That means the selling price may increase in future. So he decreases the supply today itself. Okay, one thing you remember. So expecting that price of that good to rise in future, he decreases supply today means, so he want to sell his, that means the good what he is supplying, the goods what he is supplying is not going to damage, right? So he may produce today itself, but he will not sell it. He will store in the stock. He will store that particular good in the stock and he will sell that particular good when there is increase in the selling price of the products. Do you understand? So to do so, what he is doing is, he is decreasing the supply today. He is decreasing supply today. Why? Because in near future there will be increase in the selling price. So he is supplying the decreasing supply today itself. So first one you see in the third point itself you see, expecting input prices to fall in future, increasing the supply today. So input prices in the sense that cost, that means his cost is going to decrease. His cost is going to decrease and sometimes he may increase the supply itself. Okay. So if it is going to damage, if the goods are going to damage, means he will be selling those goods immediately, right? At whatever cost it may be. See here, number of sellers is more, market supply increases. Okay. So we will know what market supply is. Okay. The number of sellers is more, market supply increases. Okay. I am going to produce one variety of ice cream. So there may be other company who is producing the ice creams. There may be another company who is going to produce the ice cream. So the total market of ice cream is there, right? Okay. If there are more number of sellers, there will be more supply. There will be more supply of ice cream to the market, right? Do you understand? If the number of sellers are more, automatically the supply to the market of ice creams will be more, right? So not only that, technology is also going to affect. Technology is also going to affect the supply, right? So new technology, new products. So the selling of the old products is going to fall, right? So as the technology is going to increase, new technology, new products, okay? So the supply of the old products is going to fall, right? For example, already the telecom companies are willing to give 5G service in near future. So automatically the mobile manufacturing companies, they are not willing to produce more number of 4G mobiles. They are thinking of producing the 5G mobiles only in near future. Why? Because in near future the 5G services are going to come into existence. So the customers are willing to buy the 5G enabled or 5G facility enabled mobiles now itself, right? When the customer is willing to buy a particular product, if he is able to spend around 40,000 to 50,000, he will be thinking of near future 5G is going to come. So it's not a good idea of buying a 4G mobile for 50,000 itself. Even by adding some more 5,000 or 10,000, if he is able to get 5G mobile, he will be buying that only, right? So technology is also going to affect the supply, right? So the same company who is producing the cell phones, he decreases the supply of 4G mobiles and he will increase the supply of 5G mobiles if he is already manufacturing, right? Next, time period also matters. More time, higher the supply. Okay. If the dealer gives more time to the producer, he will supply more amount of goods to the dealer, right? If the time period is very less, he can't produce more amount of goods, and he can't produce give it to the seller, right? That means dealer will be supplying to the seller, right? Prices of the inputs, okay, prices of the inputs also varies. This supply of the particular good, right? So cost of production increases. If the cost of production increases, example, say if the cost of production increases, automatically we expect that selling price has to be increased. But if the selling price is not going to increase, we will reduce the supply, right? Okay, example, wages are affects supply. Supply to decrease, right? Right. So changes in the quantity supplied, changes in the quantity supplied versus changes in the supply. You can see here, changes in the quantity supplied, also called as movement along a given supply curve, right? So changes in the supply, it is going to shift the supply curve, right? Okay, those things we'll be learning in detail in the next slides. So change in the quantity, this is the quantity, supplied, and this is the price of the product. Okay, quantity supplied and the price of the product. So change in the quantity supplied on a demand curve, change in the quantity supplied on a demand curve, sorry, supply curve, any increase or decrease in the price will cause the quantity supply to increase or decrease the quantity supply to increase or decrease. If the price of the product, so it is zero, right? This is P naught. If it is initially the price of the product what you are supplying is P naught, if it is increased to P1, automatically the quantity supplied is increased to B, right? If the price of the product from P1, if it falls to P0, automatically it falls back to this point. Okay, we don't expect, actually it may not be exactly like a straight line, it may be just like a curve. Okay, so see here how it is going to shift. It shifts to right as there is increase in the supply. Okay, this is the original curve. S1 is the original curve. If you think, it can shift to right as increase in the supply. If there is increase in the supply, it shifts to rightward. It shifts rightward. That means S2 is the curve as there is increase in the supply. If there is decrease in the supply, it moves left, right? So if the supply increases, the supply curve is going to move rightward. If the supply is going to decrease, the supply curve is going to move leftward, right? So what is this market supply? Market supply means, So there are taking the example of ice creams, right? So A is one company which is going to produce ice creams, and B is another company, it is also going to produce ice creams. C is also another company which is going to produce ice creams. Likewise, we have some n number of companies we have who are going to supply us the ice creams. When we want to know the market supply, we have to do the summation of all these products, right? That means company A is to produce some 1000 number of ice creams. Company B is going to produce 2000 number of ice creams. Company C is going to produce 3000 number of ice creams. So what is the market supply? So company C is going to produce 3000, company B is going to produce 2000, and company A is going to produce 1. That means going to supply, not produce, they are ready to supply these things. So 3000 plus 2000 plus 1000, so total it is 6000. 6000 is the market supply. Okay, so you have to add all the suppliers. You see here, at price 1, quantity supplied by company A is Q1, quantity supplied by market B is 8, quantity supplied by market C is 12. So at a selling price of 1, the market supply is 25. At a price of 2, that means market selling price of 2, at a market selling price of 2, we have a market supply of 32. Just we are summating it. If Q1 is not going to produce at a cost of 2, if it is 0, we have to add these 2 only, right? That means he is not going to produce a product which costs, that means whose selling price is 2 rupees, for example. Okay, so if the selling price is at 5, he is going to produce, so that means he is going to sell 13. He is willing to supply 13 goods, he is willing to supply 16 goods, and he is willing to supply 24 goods, right? So at a price of 5, at a selling price of 5, the total market supply is around 53. Okay, but it is out of this 53, 13 is from this company A, and 16 is from company B, and 24 is from company C, right? So see market supply diagram. So this 1, 2, 3 are different types of companies. This is one company, this is two companies, this is third company, right? At that particular point of time, if the price is at 3, at that particular point of time, he's going to supply 9. He's going to supply 12. This market, the company 3 is going to supply 18. So this total market means we had summed it, right? 9, 12 plus 8, if you summed it, it is around 39. This is the total market supply curve, right? So elasticity of supply, we don't have it, but we'll see. So elasticity of supply is the responsiveness of the quantity supplied to the change in the price. Okay. Elasticity of supply is the responsiveness of the quantity supplied to a change in the price. There is change in the price of the product in the market, that is selling price of the product, right? How it is going to vary, you have to see that, right? So this is the elasticity of supply. Okay, supply elasticity, as elasticities, right? Supply elasticities, as the rate of increase in the quantity. If there is increase in the rate of quantity, there will be rate of increase in the price, right? The quantity previously the quantity demanded is Q naught. Now it is Q1. So you can see it is increasing, right? Elasticity, rate of increase in the quantity, also the rate of increase in the price. We already know that as there is increase in the quantity supplied, that means as the price increases, the quantity also increases, right? Here the elasticity ES is greater, inelastic, right? Quantity supply responds at a rate lower than the change in the price. So how we are determining here, you see, elastic, perfectly elastic, inelastic, the thing we have already seen, right? Unit elasticity. If this is unity, that means this difference between P1 minus P0 divided by Q1 minus Q0, if it is unity, then we say it is unit elasticity of demand. Okay, if that value is greater than 1, that is called as elasticity of supply. If it is less than 1, we call it as inelasticity supply. Okay, even though the price of the product has increased a lot, the quantity supplied is not increased in that fashion. It is called as inelasticity of supply. Okay, even though if the price of the product has decreased a lot, the quantity demanded is not decreased in such a fashion. That is elasticity, right? Right. Unitary elasticity, you see here. Change in the quantity to, that means the value, if it is P1 minus P0 is divided by Q1 minus Q0 will be equal to 1, right? So perfectly inelastic and perfectly elastic, you see here, regarding the supply. There is no response of QS to the change in the price. So even though the price of the product has increased to P1, the supply has not increased. It is same, right? Even though the price has increased, see here, the supply, this is the quantity being supplied, right? There is no change, the same value. Okay, see here, perfectly elastic and perfectly inelastic, you see here. This is perfectly inelastic. It is not going to bother regarding the supply is not going to bother regarding the changes in the price. Okay, so here you can see, even though the price of the product is constant, the price of the here the price of the product is constant. So at that particular price only, we have huge amount of, that means the quantity supplied will be increased, right? We have different short answer questions on this. Okay. Wait a bit. So what is supply? It is willingness to offer the market at a various prices during the time period of time. Okay, definition of supply, we have different definitions for the supply. Okay, the supply of the goods in a is the quantity of for sale in a given market at a given time of various prices. So these are different determinants of the supply: price of the good, price of the related goods. So for ice cream, the related goods are just there. Related goods are just milk, transportation, refrigeration of the product, like this. Okay, price of the factors of production, price of the factors of the production, in the sense even though we have huge amount of demand for that particular product, but we may not have the machinery to produce to meet that particular demand, right? It is also going to affect, right? Price of the factors of the production and the state of the technology also. government policies. Even though we may have huge amount of demand, we can't supply more amount sometimes due to the government policies, right? Due to the government policies, we may not supply huge amount also, right? So for example, you can see there may be a huge demand, there may be huge demand for the cigarettes and the liquor, but government has to control that, so there will not be more amount of supply of such type of goods, right? And also we may have other factors also. So price of the commodity, other things being equal, relative price of the goods, if the relative price of the goods increases, the quantity supply will also increase. The price of the related goods increases, the quantity supply of the other goods decreasing. Okay, you see here. So we have some other determinants, government policies. So subsidies reduce the cost of the production, which increases the firm's supply. Okay, this type of, there will be some certain conditions. For what our law of supply is not going to work, right? So this is the thing what we will be following. Law of supply. Law of supply states that all other things being equal means constant. Okay, all other things being constant, the higher the price, the greater the quantity supplied, or the lower the price, the smaller the quantity supplied. Okay, Lipsy, he also given the same type on the law of supply states that other things being the equal, the quantity of any commodity that firms will produce or offer for sale is positively related to the commodity's own price, rising when price rises and falling when price falls. Generally, this is the law of supply, is this only what we used to follow, right? Law of supply states that other things remaining constant, the higher the price, the greater the quantity supplied, or the lower the price, the smaller the quantity supplied. Okay, so these the things, law of supplies and different types of phenomena, assumptions. So here we at most see this supply function. You have to keep this in mind, right? Supply function Qx, that means the quantity supplied. If x is the good, the quantity supplied, x is the good, right? Supply of the commodity x, the supply of the commodity x, qx is going to depend on the px, price of the commodity x, and the cost of the production of the commodity x, and the technology of its production, and also we have objective of the particular product. That means the objective of the company. Okay, if the company is willing to make more profits, as the selling price is reduced, he will be reducing supply. Okay, so if his objective is not to make more profits, he will not make more supply, right? Right. Okay. So this is the individual supply schedule, right? For single supplier at particular 1 rupee kg, he is going to supply only 10. If it is at 5 rupees, it is going to he is going to supply 80 kgs. Market supply schedule is nothing but just we are adding all those components. Supply A, supply B, we both add it, we get that at rupees of 100 of commodity X, we are going to have 90 units in the market, right? At that particular point, right? This is the individual supply curve. This is the market supply curve. Previously, we have seen it as a straight line. Now it is different, right? So we have some exceptions for the law of supply also. Supply of labor, okay. Sometimes the labor may have higher wages, okay. Agricultural products, okay. See, we have a discussion on the next class also, if possible, on the supply itself. Okay, see you in the next class.